All right, so another reason you clicked on the video. Want to see it? Here it is. This is the MPC One Retro Edition. This is a smaller standalone unit that takes its looks and functionality from its grandfather. Here are the specs. Quad-core ARM processor, 2 gigs of RAM, 1 MIDI in and out, memory card slot in the front with a headphone jack, network port, Bluetooth and Wi-Fi connections, 4 CV that turns into 8 outs with a split. So to give you some perspective, let's talk about the specs of the MPC60. It only had 768 kilobytes of RAM expandable to 1.5 megabytes and an Intel chip that ran at 6 megahertz to about 25 megahertz. The MPC One Retro has 2 gigabits of RAM with a 4-core ARM processor. This MPC's form factor is laid out in a more traditional way, which makes it more familiar to the touch, and even the screen is slightly smaller than its bigger cousins. It still provides good functionality and, in my opinion, a little bit better than my MPC Live. When Akai released the MPC One a while ago, the concept was cool but didn't really stick out to me as much like the MPC Live 2 Retro Edition, which itself looks amazing to me. When I first laid eyes on this one and took it out of the box, although it may be just in my head, it felt like I was connecting with something from the past. It felt like I had a machine or a computer. It felt like I had some breakthrough technology from the 80s. The transition from the MPC Live was very easy, as a lot of muscle memory quickly translated to this form factor. And there were some surprises now, because there are more dedicated buttons dedicated to more dedicated functions. All right, so you've seen it, you've seen the front, you've seen the back, you've seen the sides. And honestly, this is like a full circle moment for me, because, you know, when I was a kid, I couldn't really get my hands on one of these. There's no way I could convince my parents to drop more than 2 grand on the MPC product. So now I have one in my hand. And I just like the form factor. The pads feel good, the screen is cool. I made some beats on this thing already. And one of the more interesting things about this is just sampling it. Now, one of the things I wish it did have more of was a dedicated place for a hard drive, but there's no place to install like a solid state drive or anything like that. And of course, we don't have those multiple ins and outs, but as far as portability, like, to me, this fits a little bit better in a backpack than the Live does. But at the same time, visually, just the old colors, I think there's a reason why Akai selected these colors in the first place. I think it's highly visual, but it has kind of like that clinical thing. I think it takes coming from that clinical thing to, I don't know, it's just something psychological about it. Like I said before, might be something in my head, but everything works very well. I do wish the pads were a little bigger, but it didn't really stop the show going on. And I've seen clips and pictures of people who use battery packs to make this all-in-one portable thing like the Live, so that's pretty cool. And then you got a SD card in the front, which I showed you before. Here's the thing is, you know, it's interesting because if you think about a SCSI or a floppy disk, how big those were, and now we're putting terabytes on these little secure digital cards here. So overall, I think it's pretty cool. And so let's talk about it. I think it's on the market for like about $699, $799. I'm quite sure the internet will let you know what the price is in the comments. And if it's your first MPC, I definitely recommend buying this. Like I said, I wish I could just go back to when I was 14 or 12 and just give myself this and say, here you go. I definitely buy this if it's your first MPC. If you already have a Live, or you have a Live 2 or X, I don't really think it's a necessary purchase, because you already got something that does pretty much everything that this does. However, this is a lot of fun. I like how it sits in my studio. And this is definitely a nice nod to the past with the vintage Akai logo on there. I like this. You know, I would beg to ask if Akai would like come out with an MPC X Retro. Let me know in the comments below. Do you think they would do something like that? I think that would be pretty cool. So, as you can see, I'm going to be reviewing a lot of things like this. If you like this type of content, let me know in the comments below. Hit that subscribe button, hit that like button, and let's keep this part going. And this is my review of the MPC One Retro Edition. Let me know what you think in the comments. I'll see you on the next video. I'm out. I'm Dilio. Peace.